Let me first just deal this min term once more, because unless we are very clear about this min term and max term, we are going to face similar problem later on. Okay, so say I have two input variables x and y. Okay, x means electricity. Say if there is no electricity, it is zero. If there is electricity, it is one, right? So if there is no electricity, assume and I have an UPS. Okay, Y means light. Okay, so if Y equal to one means the light is switched on, and Y equal to zero means the light is switched off. F means fan enable signal. Okay, so light is more important. So if you see, if there is no electricity and you are on UPS, if the light is switched on, a fan enable is low, okay, and if it is one, right, if there is electricity, then irrespective of the light switch, the fan is enabled. Is this much clear? Anybody can keep typing yes or no. Okay, yeah, you can put it in the chat box also. No problem. Okay, so that I am in sync with you all. Okay, so understood. Okay, so what is min terms? Okay, min term is just for a two variable, there are four different combinations of input. Okay, so I am just min terms is only one of the combinations. Okay, it is just a representation of one of the input combinations, M0, M1, M2, M3. Okay, this is M0, this is M1, this is M2, this is M3. Okay, this three comes from the decimal equivalent of this input combination. So min term is nothing. Okay, M0 to M1, it is only a representation of the input combinations. So if I have a three input system, I will have eight min terms. Okay, so a min term is only a representation of the input combination. Okay, now what is this? This is the way this min term is implemented. Okay, this min term can be implemented by x bar y bar. That means when the input, what does x bar y bar means? When will x bar y bar will be one? Only in one particular condition, when x is equal to 0, y is equal to 0, x bar y bar will be one and m0 will be one. So these are the input combinations for which m0 will be high. This is the input particular for all other combinations. Okay, this will be, if I implement M1, I have to implement it as X bar Y. So if you see, if X is equal to 0 and Y is equal to 0, then you will have this as 0 coming. So this will go high only when this particular combination is available. Okay, so this is implementation of this. Okay, these AND gates, these are all AND gates. These are implementation of this min terms. Till here, is it clear? Can somebody just, if there is any doubt, please let me know. Okay. So this is just an implementation of the min terms through the AND gates. Now, I have a function which is true for multiple input combinations, right? It should be high. The fan should be enabled in this. Yeah, tell me. So let's start this all over again. You are able to hear me and see the presentation, right? Okay. So I'm sorry for all this disturbance. I just couldn't help it. Okay. So I was talking. Let's first start with the min terms. So whatever is the confusion with min terms, let's try and clear that. I said that each min term is nothing but only a representation of the various input combinations here, right? I had explained you. Okay, see, X, if I take it as an electrical power, it indicates whether there is an electricity or not. Y indicates whether the light is switched on or not, and F indicates if the fan is enabled or not. Okay, so if you have no electricity and if the light is switched on, I don't want the fan also to come on, because this working on an inverter, I don't want to load the inverter too much. Okay, so So it is 1 and 0. Okay. So similarly, if there is an electricity there, right, irrespective of my light, whether it is switched on or off, right, then it will be, the fan will be 1 and 1. Okay. Is it okay till here? Can somebody prompt yes or no so that I know there is no technical. Okay. Yes. Okay. Okay, sir. So this is what. So this is the various conditions which we are now M0 can be implemented by this X bar Y bar. If you see M0 will be 1 when X bar X is 0, Y is 0 because it is bar out here. So only in when X is 0, this will become 1 and this is an AND gate. So Y is equal to 0, only then M will be 1. So these are the various input conditions. So when I have to generate F3, so I will have a collection of all the individual min terms. So I want the fan to be enabled for this condition and this condition. That means it has to be enabled for M0, M2 and M3. M0, M2, M3 is only that particular input condition. So for these three conditions, F3 will be high. So I can write it like this also, summation of M3, M0 to 3. Okay, is this much clear? Is this part clear? Okay, yeah, tell me. Yeah. Yeah, for M1. No, X dash M1 I have written X dash Y, right? That means M1 will be when X is equal to 0 and Y is equal to 1, correct? Yeah, X is 0, X. No. Okay. This is not linked with this. Okay. This is how M1 will look like. Okay. This F, these are all the four M's are given here. And out of the four, I am not picking up M1 here. If you see here, M1 is not, I am not picking up M1. Okay. Is it okay? Okay. This is all possible combinations of M. And this is how all the M's will be implemented. Out of these four, only three I am picking up. Okay. So how do I implement it? I implement it like this. Okay. These are AND gates. I am taking only three and putting an OR gate. This is how I am implementing it. I am leaving aside M1 because I don't want M1. Is it okay how this is implemented? Now, is it clear what is min term? Anyone, if you, yeah, tell me. No, I couldn't understand. There's a lot of static noise in your mic. Yeah. No, if you see. Okay, this OR gate, right? I'm not able to hear you better. Actually, this is an OR gate. This is M0, M1, M2, M3. Okay, for 0, 0, this will be high, right? For 0, 1, right? For 0, 1, this will be high. But I don't want that condition, right? For 0, 1, I don't want F3 to be high. That is why I have not taken this connection here, right? For 1, 0, this will be high. I want that connection. And for 1, 1 also, I want. So I have taken inputs of only those min terms which I require. Is it clear? Is it clear? Now, is the concept of min terms clear? Min terms is only all input combinations. And whatever combinations I require, I will put an OR gate. Is it clear now? Okay. Yeah, tell me. This is an OR gate. Yeah, that is an OR gate. See, it depends. If you have, if I am going to, that depends on how many minterms I want to do or right when I implement. No, see, this is an two input system, right? There are two inputs, so four different minterms will come, right? So it can have so accordingly it should handle four inputs, right? But four inputs will not make sense. If it is four inputs, that means it is always one. So I've taken a three input. If it is a three input one, this OR gate will have eight, it should have at least seven inputs. Is it okay now? Okay. The fan is enabled in the output, the gate is a three input OR gate. Okay. So this is how this. Okay. Now max term. Okay. Now let's see max. What is max term? Okay. So this is slightly confusing, but if you keep your mind open, you'll find it is not that. Okay. Max term is again, right? Again, a representation of the input combination. M0 is 00. Right, M1 is 01, okay, 10 is M2, 11 is M3, right? This and small M3, they are exactly representing the same input vectors, input conditions. Only difference is the way it is implemented, okay? Now, M0 is implemented as X plus Y, okay? So, what happens if you implement M0 as X plus Y? Okay, M0 will be 0 for 00 and it will be 1 for all other conditions. Is it clear? Right? So, if you have a min term, okay, min term will be implemented in hardware as X and Y. Right? And that time, this min term will be 1 only for that particular combination. And it will be 0 for all other combinations, right? In max term, okay, max term also represents the same input combination, but it is implemented with an OR gate instead of an AND gate. Now, if you implement with an OR gate instead of an AND gate, this M0 will be 0 for this input combination and it will be 1 for all other combinations. Is it clear? Okay. So it is slight. So it here we are now trying to put it the other way around. Okay. So this M0 is we are trying to make a zero. Okay. So this instead of AND, it is become an OR gate. Right. So now it is see, it is the file length function is zero. We want a zero here. So now I want a zero here. I want a zero here. I want zeros in three different conditions. Okay. Now this is so I have picked up M0, M2, and M3, right? And it has to be an AND function, right? In earlier case, it was an OR function. Now it has to be an OR function because if you are going to OR 0 and 1 condition, okay, it will give 1. So you have to use an since you are using an OR here, you need to use an AND out here. So this is how the max term will be represented. Is it okay? This F3 I have just chosen randomly. Okay, I can give a live example also for that. Okay, suppose 0. Zero is electricity. Okay, suppose zero is electricity and one means it's an emergency light switch. So if there is no electricity, if I am switching on the emergency light, it should come on. And if there is electricity, even if I switch on the emergency switch light, the light should not come on. So this is one random variable function which I have. So this is a live example of where it might be required. So if I see the implementation now, okay, these are all OR gates, right? So electricity switch and this is the switch. Okay. So now if you see when there is electricity, it will be 1 out here, right? So, and if I'm switching on the switch, I'll get a 1 out here. But what happens here, if you see, if there is an electricity, it will be 0 out here, right? It will be 0 out here, right? If the switch is 0, right? If the switch is 0 here, you will have 0 here. So this will be disabled. This gate will be disabled if there is an electricity. If there is an electricity, it is 1 here. If the switch is switched on, it will be 1 here. If there is electricity, it will be 0 here. If the switch is in off condition, if it is in on condition, it will be 0 here. It will be 0 here. So it will be, you know, the final output will be 0. So this output will only be available when there is no electricity, right? And the switch is on. Okay. In that case, this will be, all of them will be 1 here and you will get an output light here, right? So is it okay? It is like for the minterms, we had all AND gates and a OR gate. For a match term, it is all OR gates and an AND gate. So this is the kind of thing, you know, it is done here. Is it clear? Has anybody got doubts with this? Okay, because if we include it when X is in, see, you can check this. I'll share these, you know, slides also with you, right? This is right min terms. Okay, this is 1s for the three. So you group all the 1s max terms and you are going to implement with and OR. This is a second example where you are grouping all the zeros. So each zero will be represented by a max term by this equation, and we are going to implement it by this. So if you try out all the combinations on a piece of pen and paper, it will be very clear. You will get 1 only in this particular condition, 0 and 1. Okay, only in this condition you will find a 1 here. Is it clear till here? Okay, now if you see, this is minterm. So there are so many gates are used, right? So this although this function can be realized by using minterms, it may not be the optimum solution. It might use large number of gates. Some of the gates might be redundant. Okay, some of the gates might be redundant in the way we are doing it. So we have to optimize and use the least number possible number of gates. So that is why we use K-maps. So what is the advantage? In the canonical expression, okay, all the variables will be used, right? In the canonical expression implementation, if you see here, right, this has got 2 inputs. They are all 2 inputs. All the gates are 2 inputs. If it is a 3 input variable, they will all be, there will be 8 such gates and each one of them will have all the 3. When we are doing direct implementation of the canonical form, we'll have to generate all the minterms. To generate all the minterms, we'll use all the 3 inputs. We'll have to use all the 3 inputs. Okay, and each minterm will have to be generated, and the required number of minterms will require to be AND operation is to be done if it is a max one. If it is a minterm, and OR operation requires to be done. So it requires large number of gates to do that. Okay, so that is why we can simplify. Some of the gates will be redundant. Okay, so how to simplify? We can do algebraic means also, which we did some examples, and in the tutorials which I uploaded, you will see, and you will, you know, a few more examples are given how to simplify an expression using algebraic means. But you know, algebraic means, there is no specific rules. Okay, you will have to try and apply some rules, and we do even after applying, we'll not be sure whether that is the most optimized solution or not. So that is why we use K-map method. It is Carnot map. It is pretty simple, straightforward. It is a pictorial understanding for human beings. Okay, the computer doesn't use this method. It's only for human beings, pictorial understanding. And it can give the kind of implementations, SOP and POS form. Right? It can give both kind of results. Okay, so how to make a K-map? So this is X, Y. And this is a function which for 0, 0, it is a random function which I have taken. Okay, 0, 0, 1 for this system should be 0. So these are minterms. Okay, minterm 0, minterm 2, and minterm 3. Okay, so we make a table. Okay, so this is x, this row stands for x is equal to 0, this row stands for x is equal to 1, this column stands for y is equal to 0, and this column stands for y equal to 1, right? So this, once we make a table like this, right, so we have to so this is 0 0, this is 0 1, this is 1 0, and this is 1 1. Okay, 0 0, 0 1, 1 0, and 1 1. Okay, this is, these are the columns. Okay, now wherever 1 is required, we are going to map these ones here. Okay, so this is the first step. What we do, we are going to make a table and map all the ones into this table. This is the very first step we do. Now, before going on to we should also know key how each of these will be implemented, right? So we know each minterm can be implemented. 0 0 will be implemented as x bar y bar, right? And 0 1 will be x bar y, 1 will be y x bar, and 1 will be x y. Okay, not this one, this entire box will be implemented. 1 1 will be implemented by x y. Okay, 1 0 will be implemented. So this is how these are going to be implemented, right? So they are corresponding to m0, m1, m2, and m3, right? So if you see the why we have made this boxes, if you see these two boxes, okay, when we move from here to here, okay, there is only one bit which is varying, okay, 0 to 1. When we are moving from here to here, there is only one bit which is varying, that is 0. When we are moving from here to here, you see there is only one bit which is changing. From here to here, there is also only one bit changing. Diagonally, they are, both the bits are changing. Okay, so you can't have an diagonal combinations. If you are moving horizontally or vertically, you will find only one of them is moving at any given time. Okay, is it clear till here? Anybody has got any doubt? Okay. So now how to simplify, right? Now this is x bar y bar, this is x bar y, right? So algebraically, when we simplify x bar y bar plus x bar y bar, you take x bar common, y plus y bar, which is 1. So you get x bar, right? So we know algebraically, okay, if you club these two, it is going to come as x bar. So can we do it in K-map, how do we do it? So if you make this box like this, two adjacent mix, what is this? This is x bar, right? Because y is changing from 0 to 1. So this I can call it as simply x bar. If I make a box like this, okay, what does this box indicate? It is all possible combinations of y with x is equal to 0. So I can straight away write, seeing this, making this box, I can write this is x bar, right? Now, if you see, there are another example of a, yeah, okay, yeah, okay, okay. So I said, when we write the function, suppose this is the function, okay, it has got two ones out here, right? If it has got two ones here, I'm going to put these two ones here, right? Now, horizontally or vertically, if there are ones, two ones, I can put a box, I can combine them, and I can, from this combination, I can clearly write it is x bar, because it is x is equal to 0, y can take any values, right? It doesn't matter. So what is this? This is x bar. Is it clear? Yeah. Y is don't care in this case. Y can take any value. Okay, y is changing, right? Y is taking both the values. X is remaining constant. So that is why this expression is x bar. Is it clear? Correct. So instead of algebraic manipulation, pictorially we see that there are two ones, and we make the expression directly. So if this is the function, by making a K map, I can say f is equal to x bar. From this is what K map does. Is it okay? This is a function, truth table, and how do I implement it? It is just x bar. Straightforward, right? Okay, coming to the next example. Here, I have 1 and 1 here. This is another function. I have 1 here, 1 here. This is a different function, not related to the first function. Okay, it's an independent function, fi. So, how do I group it? I make a box out here, and then this becomes 1, right? This is 1, so it is only when x is equal to 1, both the conditions are met here, y is equal to 0 and y is equal to 1. So this is going to be x. Okay, so this function can be realized as x, simply x. Okay, is it clear till here? F is x in this example, correct? Right. So now if I take, okay, now there are enough 4 ones out here, right? So I can make this as one group, this as one group, right? This becomes x bar, this becomes x. Okay, x bar plus x is 1 actually, we know it could have been simplified further. So what I could have done is, okay, I can make a group of 4 also, right? So straight away it is 1 here, right? So I can group either as 2 or I can group as 4. So both is possible. So first we have to see if there is a bigger square which is available. If there is bigger square is not available, then we go to a smaller square. Is it okay till here? Okay, so this is simply 1, right? So it will become more clear. I will take n number of examples, so it will become more clear. Okay, now I have to realize this function. So you can see how many squares can we make? Can anybody prompt? Yeah, we can make 2 squares. One is this square, and one is, so this square stands for x. And can now somebody tell what would be this vertical square? Yeah, y dash, yeah, correct. So it will be y dash, right? So this is how, if you have a function, you put a min terms here and you write x plus y dash. So now if you see, unlike min time terms, now how to implement this, it will require just one AND gate, right? The one OR gate, correct? If this function, two variable function, is to be implemented, right, I just require one OR and one NOT gate to make y bar. Okay, now if I assume, okay, if y bar is also available initially, all complements are available, okay, this function can be implemented with x plus y bar. That means I just require one OR gate. Whereas if I write a canonical form and try to implement, I will have to generate these 3 min terms and then one OR gate. That means one AND gate, one AND gate, one AND gate, and one OR gate. So by using KMAP, okay, instead of those 3 OR gates and 3 AND gate and one OR gate, I can simply use a single OR gate. Is it clear? Is the advantage of KMAP clear? How we are? Yeah, tell me. This is okay, because this is we are grouping min terms. Okay, when we are taking ones, okay, we are grouping min terms. So it is a kind of canonical form one simplification. Okay, so whenever we are grouping one, okay, whenever we are grouping one, so this we are representing as, as individual min terms, and then we have to put an OR. Okay, if we take, so it is an extension of the canonical form type one simplification. Okay, so it will, all the boxes will be OR in this case. And will be when we collect zeros, that we'll see later on. Okay, is it okay? Yeah, tell me. Yeah, no, you have to do algebraic simplification, right? Huh, yeah, we will get this. So instead of algebraic simplification, okay. So in the graphical form, it is pretty easy, right? So in the graphical form, once you see this, it is pretty easy. When you see a four variable thing, it will become even more. When you make a five variable, it will become even more spread, right? So if you try to do algebraic simplification, and you might require some 15, 16, 20 for a three variable, it is appearing for you, okay, algebraic simplification is as good as K-map simplification. But that will not be the case when we are handling four variable, five variable, six variable K-maps, okay? There, when you see, you can see all the ones and make the groups. It will just take you 1 to 2 minutes to make. You don't have to simplify using many expressions. Is it okay? Okay. Okay. So now let's go for an three variable map. Okay. So I'll just let me move forward. Okay. Okay. Now the change what we have is important out here is when we write the this is 0, 1, it's okay. But y and z, okay, this is y is equal to 0, z is equal to 0, y is equal to 0, z is equal to 1. This is 1, 1 and then 1, 0. Okay. So this is like going like a gray code. Okay. So why do we do that is because we have to make boxes, right? And to visualize, we can make a box out here. Because between these two, there is only one input which is changing. If I write 1, 0 here, I cannot group these two. Then I have to group this and this. So it becomes difficult for us to visualize. So I am writing 1, 1 here and 1, 0 here to make visualization of groupings easy. Okay. Is it clear why I have written 1, 1 and 1, 0 like this? Yeah, I'll explain it once again. If I write 1, 0 here and if I write 1, 1 here, then I will not be able to group these two cells because there are, for grouping, the rule is only one bit should change. Okay. But here, if you see, if I write 1, 0 here, then there'll be both the bits are changing. Then I will not be able to group these two. If I write 1, 0 here and 1, 1 here, then from here to here, there is one change. So I'll have to group this and that, right? Leaving it. So visually it will become very difficult for human beings, right? Okay. So that's why if I write 1, 1 here and 1, 0, these two can be grouped. So adjacent boxes can be grouped together. Is it okay? Is it okay? Yeah. Oh, okay. So it is, but this value of 0, 1, 1, you will not write this value here. It is 0, 1, 1. So you will write F from here to here. Okay. This 0, 1, 1. Okay. F is 1 here. So this 1 will come here. Right. And 0, 1, 0, this 0 will go here. So that you will not change. Only in the table, how you write this, this is swapped between each other so that the grouping becomes easily. Okay. So we should... only thing is when we map, we should be very careful that, okay, this stands for minterm M3 and this stands for minterm M2. So if I want M2 to be 0 in this particular case, right, I'll have to write 0 here and M3 is 1 here. So I'll have to write 1 here. So this part you have to be careful. You cannot write 0, 0, 0, 1. So you don't have to write 0, 0, 0, 1 here. You'll get a wrong implementation, right? If you see from here, it is 0, 0, 0, 1. So 0, 0, 0 in the rightmost column and then 1 here. Similarly, this is going to be 0, 1, 1, 1. So I have to write 0, okay, 1, 1 here and then 1 here, right? So you have to be, it is M6 and M7 here, right? So you just have to be careful with how you are going to map your function values in this table. Okay, so that is okay. It will be pretty clear once we see some examples. Okay, now if you see these cells can be adjacent cells can be mapped easily, right? These are going to be so these are all adjacent cells which can be mapped, grouped together. This can be grouped here, this can be grouped here, this can be grouped here, this can be grouped here. Also, you can make group of four also, okay? These four or the middle four or the corner fours, okay? You cannot make a four group between 0, these two and these two, right? It has to be adjacent. So you can make a group of 4 adjacent ones also. Also, you can make between the last one, this 0, 0 and 1, 0. If you see, right? These also can be grouped. These can be grouped as a 2 box also, this one also, right? Because there is only one change. Similarly, these two can also be grouped as one, right? And similarly, if you want to make 4, the first two, the first column and the last column also can be grouped as a, you know, 4 element box. Okay, it will be very clear once we do some examples. Okay, now let's see. Once we do the examples, it will be very, very clear. Okay, I have put lot of examples here just to make things clear. Okay, so see 0, 0, 0, 1. So 0, 0, 0 and then 1 here. And then is 0, 1, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1, 1. So how do we group? Okay, so this is group. Okay, now can somebody think of what will be this? What will be the expression for this? See, what is remaining constant and what is changing? Anybody? Yeah, it is YZ. Yeah, correct. Yeah, Adarshan, you have got it right. It is 1-1, right? Ratnam also has got it correct. So this is 1-1 because X is changing. Okay, now you can group this also, right? You can group this also. So this is 1-1, this is YZ, this is X is equal to, okay, and this is, okay, what is this? Okay, let me go, okay, what is this blue one? Anybody? Yeah, you have written all the answers already. Blue is X is equal to 1 and in here, Y is changing to XZ. Similarly, in this, X is equal to 1 and Z is changing, so it becomes XZ. Okay. Now, you should be asking me, sir, once we have made this one box, can I take this individually and this individually? You can do that also, right? So, what will happen in that case? It will be YZ plus, okay, the what is this? Single, it will be X Y bar Z plus this will be X Y Z bar, right? Now, if you see, if you take individually gates like that, it will be a bigger gate. It will not be that simplified. So, even at the cost of these box overlapping, if I can make a bigger box, I will go for a bigger box. Is that aspect clear? Even if you have to see that each for each element, I have to make the biggest possible box. That is the funda out here, right? You have to make, you have to cover each of these ones with a box. And for each of the box, each of these ones, whatever is the maximum possible box you have to make, right? So you will have to make each maximum possible box and the box size can be 2, 4, it cannot be 3, right? If you make a 3, if you try to club these 3, you will not get an expression for that, okay? It will be always even, 2, 4 like that, okay? So, if you see, so even at the cost of overlap, you have to use whatever is the maximum possible box size for each of these elements till all the elements are covered. Is it okay till here? Anybody? Okay. Yeah. Anybody has got a doubt? Okay. Let's go for one more example. Right? Okay. So, can somebody tell how many boxes will be there? Three box, four box. Three box. Okay. Somebody has written to Rohit, Rishabh. Yeah. Okay. Can you tell those two box people, can you just prompt the answer? One common, and yeah, Shreyas, you also got it. Okay, yeah, many of you have got it correctly. So this is going to be the one box, right? X bar, X, Y bar, and this is the this. See, this is one way of implementing it, but that's not the correct way. You can make a four box. You can make a box with four elements, right? And what will that four elements stand for? Anybody? You can switch your mic and tell. What is this four box, the expression for this? Yeah. Yeah. Muskan, Ruben, you all got it. It is going to be Z bar, right? You just have to see, I know, what is not changing, right? In this four, and X is changing. Y is also changing. See, it is Y is 0 here. Here, Y is 1. What is not changing? For all these things, it is 0 here, right? So, only Z. So, which is going to remain constant, right? Obviously, when you make a 4 box, there will be only one variable. If you are making a 2 box, there will be 2 variable. Okay, 4 box means, you are, so this is an, you have to remember, when you are making bigger box, it will simplify the expression. So, you will always target. Okay, that is the reason I said, we should always see the 4 box has got just Z bar, whereas the 2 box has got 2 variables. That means the bigger the box, the expression will be smaller. So that's why first we have to look that what is the maximum biggest size boxes which is possible. Okay, so you have to do that. And then you whatever is the leftover, again with the leftover also you have to target. Here I could have, after making this 4 box, I could have taken this only 1 also. But I should not do that. It will give me a 3 expression 1, right? If you target one, you will, if you target, make a small box here, if you see, that will be very, very redundant. I will have to write, okay, X, Y bar, Z, okay? That is just a redundant one more expression you are adding. So you will always go for something which is biggest possible. Is it okay? For 3 variable, right? Now there is one few more examples. Right, in this case, can you tell how many boxes will be there? Yeah, so there will be 2 boxes, correct? So this will be the expression, right, for the, in this case, right? So again, one more example. Yeah, in this case, no, many of you are getting 3 boxes also. See, yeah, 2 boxes is the right answer. We can club these 2 also. Okay, this is okay. This is Y and Z, and this is going to be right S and